And welcome back to the John Fitzgerald Gymnasium for the final game of the first night. And this should be a great matchup. The feature game of the night, the St. Mary's Rams of Stockton. They finished last year ranked number 2 in the entire nation. They take on the Menlo-Atherton Bears. Hello, everyone. I'm Dave Cox, along with Joe Passalacqua. And, boy, if you're looking for high-level basketball, you're going to see it right here in this game.
This is as good as it gets for high school basketball in the state of California. We have two top-notch programs here, so I'm really looking forward to watching St. Mary's from Stockton. I'm also looking forward to watching Menlo, who brings back 8 returners from last year's team. I expect them to be very strong tonight.
No doubt about that, as the Menlo-Atherton Bears getting their starters announced right now. And they're a very proud program. You know, when they saw this bracket come out, they were like, oh man, we got to play St. Mary's right off the bat. But they're a capable team, and you never know what can happen.
Exactly. And you know what? You want to test yourself with the best competition early on. There's no point in playing teams that aren't going to challenge you. So give both these teams credit for coming to this tournament and playing great competition.
Markeisha Coleman, the head coach for the Menlo-Atherton Bears in her 5th year, and they were 27-5 last year. So they have a lot of players returning from that squad, including a bunch of sophomores, but St. Mary's has a couple of very high-level players. Najee Murray, who's going to San Diego State. They also have one of the top freshmen in the entire country.
Yes, that's Amaya Oliver, number 13 there. But Aguirre DaCosta, number 31, she's the straw that stirs the drink, so to speak. She's a preseason All-American by Max Prex, and looking very forward to watching her play tonight.
So we are just about ready to go. The winner of this one plays Pleasant Valley, who beat Sacramento 67-54. St. Mary's of Stockton, who just a ton of players playing at the college level as well as at the professional level. We have one player over a 10-year period playing professional basketball. You've done a great job. To have 3 players currently playing tells you a lot about their program. Here they come right off the tap, trying to score early. And that ball last touched the Rams. It's going to be Menlo-Atherton's ball.
St. Mary's right off the bat getting into the press. You're going to see this all game long, Dave. St. Mary's will press and press and press some more.
Menlo-Atherton beats the press and attacks at the other end, and they get the lay-in.
And that's what I've said. If you're going to press, you better attack that press.
Quickly the other way. DaCosta no good. Offensive board. Another offensive board, and DaCosta gets the tap in. Wow.
DaCosta, as you can tell, she's very athletic, and she's going to make things happen with her athleticism tonight. She's on the front of the press. Tall, lanky. There's 2 times in a row, though, Menlo-Atherton has broken the press, and give them credit. They're being aggressive. I like that.
Greer Hoyam has scored both times down. And there's the 3 for DaCosta, who gets the tap in on one possession and then bangs the 3 of the other. And here she is again. Greer Hoyam has had 3 baskets in a row. What a
Greer
start
Hoyam
for her.
She's not afraid of the spotlight right off the bat. Here she goes. Three shots, 3 baskets. I like what Menlo-Atherton's doing. They are being aggressive. They're attacking St. Mary's press.
What a start to this one.
It's not a smart foul on Aguirre DaCosta. There again, it's Menlo-Atherton breaking the press. Throwing the ball over the top of St. Mary's. St. Mary's going to have to make a little bit of adjustment there, keep somebody a little further back. You see the officials right now are telling the teams, take your bench down to the 28-foot line.
Menlo trying to split the defense and a tie-up. Possession arrow is going to favor Menlo. They'll hang on to the ball here. back-to-back Peninsula Athletic League champions.
Here's St. Mary's again. They're trapping. They're trapping everywhere, and that's what they're known for.
That one trickles in and out. Menlo-Atherton with the rebound. They played in the CCS Open Division last year, finished up as a Division I team at the state level. So obviously St. Mary's was an open team last year, both Division I teams. This is one of, again, one of those games that's going to look good on your resume later on down the road. Into the corner. Nice block out for Menlo-Atherton.
Menlo-Atherton probably realizes that they don't have the quickness to hang with St. Mary's. That's why they're sitting back in the zone.
There's Oliver trying to get her game going early on. Sparrow did a nice job of rebounding there for Menlo-Atherton. And here come the Bears quickly up the floor. Sparrow again on the right wing. Double teams everywhere, trying to find that open player. And almost wide open, Carly McClanahan, and she could not receive that pass.
Right idea. She saw the open player, just did not execute.
In the right wing, and the ball gets stuck. How about that?
Shot by Carolyn Stevens, lodged up there in the rim. Kind of threw like a little bit of a knuckleball with the way that ball came off her hand and then just lodged in there.
Let's see if we can get the ball unstuck now. They do. Six-five lead for the Menlo-Atherton Bears.
You know, they play in the Peninsula Athletic League, and that's a tough league down there, so.
DaCosta takes the inbound and just powers her way up to the rack. She has all seven of St. Mary's points here in the first quarter.
I'll tell you what, her skill set is amazing right now, just watching her here in the early going.
Trying to feed that ball to Hoyam again, and she just went up with both hands above the pass. She'll try a three now.
Very quick release there by Gary.
Sparrow
DaCosta
has the rebound. Menlo handling the pressure well. And right as I say that, they lose the handle. McClanahan turning it over there. A one-point lead to St. Mary's.
It's a double-edged sword. You want to attack the press, but you want to attack it under control. And some of the Menlo-Atherton girls are going a little too fast for themselves. There we see have a travel right there, just like I was talking about. It's an unforced turnover because you're perceiving what's going to happen to you with two girls running at you.
Three from the right wing, no good. Offensive rebound, Oliver goes up strong. Maya Oliver will go to the free throw line. She is the freshman that Joe was talking about.
She makes up one of the twin towers there with Agiria DaCosta. I mean, look at the size that St. Mary's has here between Maya Oliver and Agiria DaCosta. And although they're very tall and lanky, they can both play inside and outside, as you've seen from Acosta shooting two threes already, knocking down one.
And Oliver makes it 8-6 as she gets one of two.
She had a nice shooting touch right there. A little confusion.
She thought she was trying to get repositioned for the press, but she was actually repositioned to the bench right there. Steal DaCosta. Nice pass. DaCosta gives it up. And DaCosta comes down with it again. Where DaCosta. That shot no good.
She rushed her shot. She didn't get turned and squared up to the basket. What Menlo-Atherton has to watch out for here is the adjustments that St. Mary's are making. They're mixing up their press. They went from a full-court press to like a half-court 2-2-1 press. And right off the bat, Menlo-Atherton turned it over.
Thank our sponsors once again, North Bay Elite, Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supplies, our title sponsor, The Loft Salon, Lepe's Taqueria, Malloy Insurance, Irvine Real Estate, Judy Groverman Walker, JGW Events, Striping Graphics, and Canterbury's Delicatessen. It's been a great first day of action. A couple blowouts, but you can always kind of expect that to happen. Actually, the Campo St. Mary's game ended up being pretty close at the end, although Campo had built up a 20-point lead at one point. The lead was down under 10 in the last minute of play. Menlo trying to find an answer on the offensive end. Offensive rebound was almost it, but DaCosta comes down with the next rebound. And now St. Mary's with 3:25 to go in the first quarter will try and add to a two-point lead. Left wing, good. Nice basket by Nina Young.
That was a deep three right there by Nina Young.
And there's DaCosta creating havoc, getting the turnover. Outside shot, rattles the rim, no good. It's been a while since Menlo-Atherton scored. They were able to get a couple of baskets beating the press, and then in their half-court game, they just have not been able to score against the St. Mary's.
Again, St. Mary's just mixed up the press again. They went from a 2-2-1 to a 1-2-2 here. So again, it's a trapping concept. They're very aggressive, and there's a turnover right there.
Lay-in, St. Mary's.
Turnover leads to 2 points for St. Mary's. Menlo-Atherton has to be careful, or this could get out of control early here.
Ariel Johnson with that basket. Menlo trying to answer, but there's DaCosta skying for the rebound. DaCosta coming down with that loose ball, but here comes Menlo-Atherton now. And wide open at the other end, they finally get a basket as Kalahi gets the basket.
And that was an assist from Stella Kalahi to her sister Mela Kalahi.
Tom Gonzalez, the St. Mary's coach, not real happy with the officials right now.
Well, we don't have a replay here yet, but he may have been right about that missed call there.
DaCosta's going to take a little breather here. Oliver has checked back in. Kick it outside. Off the mark. Here comes Menlo-Atherton now. Trailing by five. Nice drive to the rack. And the basket good for Stella Kalahi.
Well, every basket for Menlo-Atherton has come on a layup in the paint.
And there's the three at the other end by Nina Young, her second three.
And again, that was deep. She's literally about 5 feet beyond the stripe. So that's tough to guard.
And a foul call at the other end, so Menlo's going to get a chance to shoot free throws. It'll be Mila Kalahi who will shoot the free throws here.
Here we go right here. We're seeing St. Mary's come down and a little kick out to the wing. And Nina Young nails a deep three.
Mila Kalahi will try to add to the 10-point total, and she's all net on the first one. Nice touch. She has 3 points now in this first quarter. Rebound to Costa. Lahi gets one of two. Under a minute here in the first quarter. Another deep three. The rebound goes to Menlo-Atherton.
Again, St. Mary's likes to press, and they like to shoot a lot of threes. And they're doing that. And Menlo-Atherton's going to answer with a three.
Kalahi with a three of her own. Mile Kalahi tightens this game up. 2-point lead for St. Mary's. It looked like the Rams were starting to pull away, but Menlo-Atherton has now tightened this up. 18 seconds to go in the quarter.
Again, you see the kick out. Menlo-Atherton breaks the press. If you can break the press, you're going to get wide open looks. Here's a nice penetration kick to the corner, and Kalahi nails it.
DeCosta, who just checked back in, goes up and under and scores with the right hand. What a move. At the buzzer, no good. Off to a great start, as we anticipated in this one. 18-14, St. Mary's by four over Menlo-Atherton here in the nightcap of the Cardinal Newman Classic. We'll be back with the start of quarter number two in just a moment with a 4-point lead for St. Mary's. You want to check out what St. Mary's offers?
Are you searching for a great high school experience? Cardinal Newman is the only Catholic college preparatory high school in Santa Rosa. Be a part of a community where you will be known and supported during these key years of growth. Be a part of a fun and positive student body who embraces challenge and responsibility through faith, academics, service, visual and performing arts, and competition. Learn how to apply at cardinalnewman.org.
Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, featuring hand-split redwood posts for a beautiful split rail fence. Cameron and Cameron, delivering quality for over 40 years.
So St. Mary's with a 4-point lead as we start quarter number two.
Menlo-Atherton is essentially trying to double down on Acosta down there. They're fronting her and then trying to get one in the back, too.
Taken away by Menlo-Atherton.
Again, that's some real athleticism there by DeCosta.
And the lay-in is good. Doesn't get the first one, but she does get the second one. Greer Hoyam now has 8 points to lead the Menlo Bears.
And again, Menlo is not afraid to attack the basket here off the press, and that's been their whole offense really to speak of here so far in this game.
Three ball on the way, no good. Rebound Menlo. DeCosta tried to save that, but stepped on the line. And I tell you, Menlo looks concerned, but not intimidated. They're handling the pressure pretty well. Now, at any point in time, this different type of trapping pressing could take its toll, but right now they're handling it pretty well.
No, they are. They're only down 4 points here, 20-16. They've seen three different types of press from St. Mary's so far, and they've done a good job of breaking it. They just sometimes have to begin. Don't go too fast. That's what it comes down to. So again, St. Mary's is back in their three-quarter court, 1-2-2 trap. Menlo-Atherton has got to be strong with the basketball here. A little too much dribbling right now.
Into the corner it goes. Trying to get it down low to Greer-Hoyam. She gives up the ball, and St. Mary's ends up with the rebound. The Rams up by four, 6:10 to go, second quarter. Three ball on the way. DaCosta gets the rebound. She gets so many loose balls.
Menlo-Atherton has to be careful of not packing it in so much, worrying about DaCosta, that they're leaving these girls wide open for the three because St. Mary's can't hit those shots. And again.
Shot clock at 10. Nice pass to the cutting Ram right through the lane, Taylor Thomas.
They found the hole in the zone there. Now a nice ball movement by St. Mary's. Strong move. But she was a little bit short there because she saw Acosta in the lane. She pulled back on her shot.
Playing catch beyond the arc, firing up the three, and there's DaCosta. Basket does not count. She was fouled before she was able to go back up a bit.
Yeah, you can see right there, Acosta's athleticism is definitely on display. She's jumping, you know, a couple, 2 to 3 inches at least higher than the other girls right there. And clearly that's her basketball if she wants it. And she did, so she got the rebound.
Thomas, bounce pass down low. DaCosta flips it up with the right hand. Oh my goodness. What a shot. There it is again.
I'm probably going to say this too much, but her athleticism is on display here. Nice baseline move there. She gets a little spin going to her right. And she's left-handed, but she flips it up with her right. Knocks it down. Now she's going to the free throw line for the old-fashioned three-point play.
That was pretty. 8-point lead. DaCosta trying to complete a three-point play. Doesn't get it. Left corner, a little strong. Hoyam keeps it alive, and she goes to the free throw line. Greer Hoyam's had a great first half.
Hey, you got to give her credit because she's in there battling. She is definitely not intimidated, and that's a strong rebound on her part. She gets fouled going back up.
She was the PAL South most valuable player last year. They return all five starters. And Hoyam makes it a 24-18 game, 6-point lead now. Menlo trying to dig in defensively. Thomas for three. DaCosta keeps it alive, a little strong. St. Mary's relentless on the offensive glass.
That is a great word, relentless on the offensive glass, because they're killing Menlo-Atherton on the offensive boards right now.
Down the lane, flipped up strong. There's DaCosta again, and she'll go back to the free throw line. Check it, that's Oliver.
Yes, and the freshman, Amaya Oliver. Again, that was the second offensive rebound in that possession that St. Mary's got. So if you can't keep them off the boards, it's going to be a long night.
Oliver gets the first. Oliver gets her own miss. DaCosta into the corner. Another offensive rebound for the Rams.
Menlo-Atherton needs to be stronger going for the ball on the defensive rebounding situation.
There's another offensive rebound. DaCosta up strong, but she traveled.
Men Menlo-Atherton got lucky there because they've also been called the foul instead of the travel. So here we are back. St. Mary's back with their press. Turnover again.
Stevens kicks it back up to DaCosta. Wide open for three, Nina Young. DaCosta hustles all the way under. Oliver keeps it alive, and it's going to stay with St. Mary's.
People want to think that it's over the back, there's a foul there, but again, Oliver and DaCosta are both just jumping straight up, and they're so tall and lanky that they're getting tipping the balls to themselves.
Nice pass to Oliver, and she lays it in, the freshman, with a very nice shot.
Nina Young, very, very nice dish and drive there. St. Mary's was given a warning by the official for touching the ball after it came through the basket. Basically, it's a delay of game call.
Yeah.
So. Another turnover by Menlo-Atherton. Starting to pile up, actually, you know that?
Nice shot, left wing, beauty, as Taylor Thomas hits the three.
What was a four-point game at the quarter is now a 12-point game. Menlo-Atherton's only scored 2 points here in the second quarter. Again, they've turned the ball over way too much. And this game.
All right, we'll step aside ourselves here with the score 30-18. We'll be right back with more from the Cardinal Newman Classic final game of the night.
Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, featuring hand-split redwood posts for a beautiful split rail fence. Cameron and Cameron, delivering quality for over 40 years. Malloy, Emery, and Vasconi Insurance Services, a professional agency with personal service, insuring wine country since 1890.
So a nice spurt by St. Mary's, Joe, as they build the lead up to 12. Don't blink, because they can score quickly, a couple turnovers, a couple baskets, and all of a sudden the lead is double digits.
Well, you're exactly right there, Dave. I mean, you turn the ball over, they come down a bang of three, and start stretching that lead out. Menlo needs to be, you know, very strong here with the basketball. Knock down a
nice shot.
There they go. Knock down a nice three.
Carly McClanahan with a much needed three. Menlo cuts the lead back to nine. And McClanahan comes down with a rebound, but then almost throws it away. Menlo somehow hangs on to the possession. DaCosta, or that's Oliver, with a rebound. Taylor Thomas. Ball still loose, and St. Mary's hangs on to it.
Again, it just comes down to the athleticism there. There's three girls right around the ball, and Menlo's can't just get up and get it.
The freshman, Amaya Oliver, kicks it back up top. And that one drops. It hit the back rim. Nina Young with the three, her third three of the ball game.
They must have, what, 5 threes so far in the game? A strong inside-outside game by St. Mary's. But the key is their pressure, the turnovers that they're creating. There's one right there. Nina Young's fouled on the layup.
And they're doing this without Najee Murray, who's injured, has an ACL injury, Division I signee at San Diego State. So imagine this team with another Division I player added into the mix.
I'm telling you what, you wouldn't know that they're missing a Division I player the way they're playing right now. But that's what depth does for you when you have this type of depth. You just, next player step up.
Nina Young at the free throw line.
Coach Gonzalez a little upset with one of his players stepping outside of her role. He didn't think that she should be shooting the ball.
Second one good for Nene Young, who has 10 points in the first half. The lead back up to 13 now with a minute and 47 to go. Actually, this is the biggest lead of the night so far for St. Mary's at 13.
St. Mary's definitely has depth. Coach Gonzalez is running different players in and out of this game. So
nice steal. Oliver getting that one. Outside shot on the way from Menlo, no good, and St. Mary's has the rebound. Rams looking to run. And there's a foul as Ariel Johnson tried to get down that lane and cut off nicely by Menlo, but she was fouled.
What's happening is Menlo's turning the ball over and it's turning into layups down the other end. You got to take care of the basketball. If you don't, the game's going to get out of hand here. A 13-point lead go to a 20-point lead in a matter of a minute or two if you don't take care of the basketball.
Minute and 15 to go here in the second quarter. See the team fouls. And Nene Young gets one of two. 14-point lead now as the Rams continue to build the lead up slowly but surely. Menlo having a very difficult time in the half-court game. And there's a foul as they did finally get it across that time. And Ilana Bear was fouled.
One of the attributes of a good team is when you think that you have them beat by good ball movement, is that they can recover defensively, and that's what you're seeing from St. Mary's. You know, you think that, hey, I'm hitting the old man, but next thing you know, she's covered. They're really aggressive, and they're moving on defense. So I give St. Mary's Stockton a lot of credit with their defensive intensity.
Oh, nice play. St. Mary's defense has been very strong, particularly in the half court. Now here comes Menlo trying to get it back in an over and back call. Great hustle that time by Stella Kalahi. DaCosta, nice pass, making that one extra pass, and then DaCosta ends up with another rebound, ball on the floor. St. Mary's hangs onto it somehow. DaCosta again. And I tell you what, Menlo, they're fighting hard. It's hard to compete with DaCosta with her, not only her jumping ability, but her timing is so incredible.
Yes, and she's very strong when she gets her hands on the basketball. Very strong with the ball. And she's got the ball in her hand, and she's going to keep it, that's for sure. And this is evidence right there. We got a little inside to the corner. DaCosta goes up, pulls it down. That's her rebound. Now she's fouled. She's going to the free throw line.
She made that extra pass to Jada Moss, who didn't get it. 20 seconds to go now in this second quarter, and there's the basket by DaCosta as she adds to her point total, 12 points now. Queer DaCosta, the 6'2 junior. Got them both. Under 20 seconds to go now in the half. And Menlo throws it away. The Bears starting to unravel a little bit. I think the pressure is starting to take a toll. Halftime can't come soon enough.
It is.
For Coach Markissa Coleman.
That's consecutive turnovers, you know, back to back right there. Now the lead's again stretching out. It was 13. Here we are at 16. What's it going to be here at the half?
Throwing that one up, just a little strong. 37-21 at the half. So St. Mary's builds the lead up to 16. Menlo trying to hang in there, but just very difficult to score off the Rams in the half court. They were able to do some damage against the press early on, but the Rams keep mixing it up and finding the right combination defensively.
They kind of got away from what was successful to them, which was attacking the press and getting the ball inside the key for a layup. And then when they started passing the ball around the perimeter, and St. Mary's athleticism and their length disrupted their offensive flow. And again, St. Mary's probably had five turnovers in a row that they created against Menlo-Atherton. So we'll see what they can do, regroup at halftime.
37-21 at the half. We'll be back with more here in the Cardinal Newman Classic after this.
North Bay Elite AAU girls basketball attending the top NCAA showcases in the country, with former players competing at the NCAA Division I, II, III, and NAIA levels. Winners of two Pacific District Level 1 national qualifiers for the best in girls AAU basketball. It's the North Bay Elite.
Another offensive board to cast against them.
37-21 at the half. We're going to take a look at the highlights of the first half of play right here. Show you how we arrived at this score.
Here you see Aguirre Da Costa with a three-pointer bombing from outside, showing her all-around game right there. We got a dish and kick here now to Nina Young also. Here we are in play. We're still showing some of the highlights. Again, there's another three-pointer from Nina. Taylor Thomas was that one. This is where we're seeing Menlo-Atherton break the press. Nice job there by Greer Hulliam. She was the bright spot for Menlo in the first half. We're also again, another one, same thing, Greer home. So the highlights here. That was Menlo-Atherton's, basically their strength was attacking the press, getting the ball inside. Greer home again, but she missed it when she was fouled. So they need to do that here in the second half. They need to attack the press and be strong with the basketball. If they can do that, then they can get back in the game here. They're only down 13.
McClanahan hit a three for Menlo-Atherton to tighten it up a little bit. And then a nice stop for Menlo on defense. They got the shot clock to expire.
Again, you see Acosta there come around on Hoyam. Nice aggressive play by Hoyam to get back and tie it up, at least to slow down St. Mary's.
Peninsula Athletic League MVP.
And Nina Young make the drive, get her own rebound, but Menlo comes up with it in the scrum.
Menlo-Atherton trying to run the floor, but Da Costa steps right in front of the pass. Da Costa down the lane, no good.
Again, McClanahan's got to be stronger with the basketball. There it is. Nice
job. Hoyam. 12 points now for Hoyam.
If they just do that, if they take care of the basketball, they're going to be in this game. Again, St. Mary's going a little too fast for themselves. Menlo's coming back. Nice bounce pass there.
Hoyam got it. 14 points for Greer Hoyam. And Tom Gonzalez has seen enough of that. He calls timeout.
Down 16 to down 9 in a span of less than 2 minutes. Again, that's because Menlo-Atherton took care of the basketball. Layup, three-point shot. They're right back in it. St. Mary's got a little bit out of control there to start the third quarter, going a little bit too fast.
Cut the lead down to 9. Nice little run here for Menlo-Atherton. There you see Queer Da Costa, ranked number 6 as a junior in the country by ESPN, number 1 at her position, and she's had a great game. She does a lot of things right for St. Mary's. And such a terrific player, and I tell you what, Oliver is not far behind. You picture her 2 years down the road or 3 years down the road, she's going to be the same type of player.
Oh, for sure. And she has a mentor in Da Costa.
There's
that right there. Gets her own miss, puts it back up for an easy layup.
15 points for Da Costa. Left wing, Menlo trying to keep the momentum going. McClanahan gives it up top. And there's a three and one. Wow, Megan Sparrow.
Nice shot. And she was fouled, so she's going to the free throw line for a four-point play.
Chance for a four-point play for Sparrow.
Basket counts. Foul on Stevens, that's her first. Megan Sparrow shooting one.
A little success breeds confidence, and if Menlo-Atherton starting here in the third quarter has had some success early, and so they're getting right back into this ball game here. Only down 7 now. Stay out.
DaCosta will try and get the momentum back. Quick, oh, what a head fake. Oh, my goodness.
Very
now you
quick.
See her, now you don't.
Yes, very quick shake and bake right there by Aguirre DaCosta. There are not too many girls in the state of California that can make that play. Guarantee you. Maybe in the nation.
That is why she is ranked so highly. Here it is again.
Yeah, a little shake, head and shoulder shake. Goes to her left. Obviously, that's a strong hand. But to make that move that quickly, that's something special there.
41-32. Hoyam with the hook. Greer Hoyam has 16 points.
She's having a strong, strong game here tonight. And she's not backing down from anybody.
Great post player. Nina Young firing up the three. Menlo has the board. Chance to tighten this thing up a little bit more. But the Rams come up with a steal. Pass ahead. And the basket good by Jada Moss. She got the steal. She tipped it away. And she was rewarded at the other end with the lay-in.
A sure way to kill your momentum is to turn the ball over.
Greer Hoyam. Got a little too far under the basket that time, and Nina Young ends up blocking the shot, taking it away for the Rams. Trying to get it to Moss in the open floor, flipped up top, and Moss stepped on the line. Go the other way.
St. Mary's goes so fast all the time. Sometimes that just causes them to be just a little bit out of control. You know, throwing the ball away there on the break. It's got to kind of cut down on those mistakes, clean things up.
A little over 4 minutes to go in the quarter. Menlo trying to chip away at this lead. Sparrow thought about that three. She was definitely open. Now she gets it to Hoyam. And Greer Hoyam does it again.
Nice pass by Sparrow to give the ball up to Hoyam there.
The lead just 7 now for St. Mary's. Nina Young, a little strong, but the Rams have an offensive board and a travel.
Menlo got away with a break there because they were very flat on the defensive boards there. The Rams getting the loose ball, turned it over right back to them. Big break there for Menlo.
Coach Dom Gonzalez jumping off the bench right there, trying to sub in some fresh bodies now and see if they can keep this momentum. It's a 43-36 lead for St. Mary's. Long pass, right side. And the reach in that time by Menlo Atherton as Stella Kahalahi steps in and slaps at the ball and gets called for that.
Well, you know, Stella, she's a smart player, and that, you know, you can't be making those fouls like that, because they're going to come back and haunt you later. That's her third foul right now, and she cannot be on the bench. She needs to be in the game.
DaCosta tried to slide it to Oliver, and she wasn't quite ready.
Well, it's a great idea. Oliver's got to be ready for that pass, though, because she's wide open.
Stella brings it across now. And the basket good. That is a three for Mele Kahalai.
Well, nice three there by Menlo, but that play was made by Stella Kahalai by splitting the trap. Very strong with the basketball ripping through. We're going to see that here. See, watch her rip through, step, make the pass. And then you see Sparrow knocking down the outside shot. Not Sparrow. It was Maley, her sister.
Yeah. It's Maley again. She gets it up to Stella. The lead is just 4. And there's a travel call against Menlo, so an empty possession there. But the Bears are back in it. 2:35 to go in the third, and they trail 43-39. What a comeback.
And they're back in it because they're taking care of the basketball. They're being solid, and they're getting some good looks. And they're knocking down shots. That's a key. Look at Hoyer. Hoyam looks very tired out there. They might want to get her a break. I don't know if she's been out of the game yet at all. It looks like she's dragging a little bit.
Kalahi picked up her second. At the free throw line is Arielle Johnson for St. Mary's.
And just as I said, Hoyam looked like she needed a break. Menlo takes her out and puts in Opa Sili.
Johnson gets one of two, 5 points now for Arielle Johnson with 2:24 to go. Steal by St. Mary's. Rams are going to get the momentum back here at the end of the quarter. Three ball on the way, in and out. DaCosta goes up and gets called for the foul.
And that looked like a good call. Looked like she was over the back there.
Just two fouls on DaCosta.
Stella Khalili got away there. Unfortunately, she turned the ball over, but she got away with a break because St. Mary's wasn't able to score there. Again, they need to be stronger with the basketball. Swing it, find the open player.
Stella brings it up. Mele tries to get to the basket hard and can't get it. No good. Sparrow with the rebound. Mele Kahalai with a nice spin, but what defense by St. Mary's as they batted away, getting back. Jada Moss that time, but look out, Stella has it, and she lays it in.
There you go. Menlo-Atherton's right there, only down three right now, minute 26 to go.
Menlo hanging tough, down by three, 1:20 to go here in the third quarter.
Well, this is every bit the ball game that we were hoping for.
There's the rebound by Sparrow. Huge possession right here. Stella dumps it ahead. Mele Kahalai back up to Stella. Looking for an open player. Drive to the rack. McClanahan, she gets her own miss. Three ball to tie it. Off the mark by Kahalai.
A wide open look just to not go down.
Under 50 seconds to go. The foul and one for Nina Young. Nina Young goes right down the lane, picks up the foul. It's her first basket of the quarter, and she has 14 on the game.
Well, that's a surefire way to kind of stop the momentum of Menlo. Again, Nina Young drives right down the middle there. Nice, strong left hand. You know, it's very impressive for, you know, a right-handed shooter for her to be able to use her left hand that strongly in the lane. She completes the three-point play there.
Oliver's going to check back in now. 44.4. The lead is six. Menlo had a chance at the tie and just didn't hit the shot.
That's what they say. Every possession is an important possession. You can't be soft with the basketball. You have to be strong.
Mele has her shot blocked. Nice job by Taylor Thomas.
I think Menlo probably, the coach probably would have preferred to run a little clock there, even though it looked like it was going to be an open shot. It was way early in the shot clock. She probably only ran 5 to 6 seconds off the shot clock there before taking that three. And now you're giving St. Mary's another opportunity to score here before the quarter ends. They're going to milk it down here for the last shot.
Rams saw their lead cut to three, and there's a bump. 20 seconds to go in the quarter. Mele with the foul.
That's her third foul.
Three fouls on Mele now. Inbound underneath now for the Rams. Arielle Johnson. Back up to Arielle now. Oliver and DaCosta looking down low, and the pass is thrown away with 8.2 to go. Another huge possession coming up for the Menlo Bears.
Got 8 seconds here to get a good look. Got to be strong with the basketball.
Shot goes up, no good. Not real comfortable. Ofa Seeley wasn't really comfortable with that situation, but she had to shoot. There was no time left. She didn't have time for one more pass.
But I tell you what, Menlo-Atherton has to be, the coaching staff has to be very proud of the way the girls have battled back here in the third quarter. Like we said, they had a chance to tie the game up. It didn't happen. They're still within 6 points going into the fourth quarter.
All right, three quarters of play in the books. We'll head for the final quarter of this one in the final game of the day here in the Cardinal Newman Classic.
Are you searching for a great high school experience? Cardinal Newman is the only Catholic college preparatory high school in Santa Rosa. Be a part of a community where you will be known and supported during these key years of growth. Be a part of a fun and positive student body who embraces challenge and responsibility through faith, academics, service, visual and performing arts, and competition. Learn how to apply at cardinalnewman.org.
Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, featuring hand-split redwood posts for a beautiful split rail fence. Cameron and Cameron, delivering quality for over 40 years.
So we're ready for the final quarter, 47-41, as we put the final 8 minutes on the clock here at the John Fitzgerald Gymnasium.
Well, I'm looking forward to the last 8 minutes, Dave. It's going to be exciting here.
Rams trying to figure out who's in. That's the second time tonight they've had six players on the floor. Rams with the possession. Three ball. Good. Nina Young.
It's a great way for St. Mary's to start off the fourth quarter. Push that lead from 6-9.
Still keeping Greer Hoyam on the bench. A little surprised she didn't come off to start this fourth quarter.
She went out with 2:25 to go in the third, so I would think she's had enough rest. You want her back in the game for sure. Mele Kalahi, she needs to be strong with the basketball but not pick up her dribble.
Long pass. That's a tough pass. That's a long pass
across
the court. Cross
court passing like that, it's a surefire way to lead to a turnover.
Caroline Stevens got a finger on that. They had cut the lead to three and had a shot at a tie. Now they trail by nine. Menlo-Atherton. Pass underneath. And Nina Young is right there to step in front of it.
St. Mary's does a very good job of rotating on their traps to get to the open player. With evidence right there in that little sequence.
Sparrow tries to flip it up top. Really didn't get enough on that pass. McClanahan trying to save the possession, and a quick timeout taken by Marquisa Coleman very alertly. And we'll step aside ourselves. It's 50-41, St. Mary's over Menlo-Atherton. These teams looking to advance to the winner's bracket semifinal tomorrow.
Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, featuring hand-split redwood posts for a beautiful split rail fence. Cameron and Cameron, delivering quality for over 40 years.
Malloy, Emery, and Vasconi Insurance Services, a professional agency with personal service, insuring wine country since 1890.
So 7:13 to go in this one, and Menlo trying to hang in there now, trailing by nine.
And I'm still kind of perplexed why Menlo-Atherton coach Marquisa Coleman has not put Greer Hoyam back in the game.
Yeah, she got him back in. She had four quick baskets in that third quarter. Oh, and off the glass, Mele Kalahi. Not sure she meant to do that at all, but it's a big basket.
Well, there was, time was running out, I believe, in the shot clock. I'm not sure why she pushed it up so quickly.
A little confusion offensively, and Arielle Johnson just takes it to the rack hard, and DaCosta uses her athleticism to get the basket and one. Wow.
And Agiri DaCosta looking to get a three-point play the old-fashioned way. Again, that's just her sheer athleticism taking over there, grabbing the rebound, little spin move, dropping it down.
19 points for DaCosta. She'll try to add to that.
Here comes Hoya back in the game now.
Yeah, like I said, she should be plenty rested. She sat out for 2.5 minutes of the third quarter and almost 2 full minutes of the fourth quarter now. And here comes the Rams. DaCosta misses. Ball kept alive by Oliver. And they'll hang on to the possession. Eight-point lead for St. Mary's. Down low it goes. DaCosta back up top. Little strong. Backside offensive rebound and basket by Arielle Johnson. Did you see that?
And again, if you don't block out, if you don't block out on the defensive boards, that's what's going to happen. So Arielle Johnson sneaks in there, gets the rebound, knocks it down, going to the free throw line for the three-point play. There we are right there, as you can see.
It's like we're going to call this a flagrant foul. So, she's going to shoot one, and St. Mary's is going to get the ball back. Lead is 10. Johnson makes it 11.
Yeah, I didn't see that being a flagrant foul there, but I mean, maybe I missed it through the players.
It was a pretty strong push, but
here we go. We're seeing it again here. Just a missed rebound. She gets it.
She's going to get two technicals.
Yeah, I don't see that at all.
She makes the first technical, now her second, so she's got a chance to make it a five-point play. And she does, a five-point play.
That's an unfortunate break for Menlo, because looking at the replay there, I didn't see any sort of intentional push in the back by the Menlo-Atherton player. Again, maybe the replay is not giving us the best view, but from what I could tell, it just looked like she went down because she was off balance. And now we're back up to a 13-point lead.
So a tough break there for Menlo. The five-point play makes it a 13-point game. DaCosta disrupts another pass so quick with those hands.
Well, Menlo-Atherton needs to ball fake more, because they're not ball faking and they're trying to throw over the top. And St. Mary's is so lanky, so long, that they're getting their hands on the ball there.
Boyum misses. And Stella will go to the line. We'll get two shots, a 13-point lead for St. Mary's, but Menlo with a chance to score with the clock stop. Doesn't get either. Caroline Stevens came down with the rebound that time, and now St. Mary's will try and add to the lead. Here comes Nina Young back into the corner. Arielle Johnson.
Got Arielle Johnson and Nia Young running a little two-man game right here.
Yeah,
give
it
go.
Works. Oliver again, not quite ready for the pass. And Menlo takes it away. Oliver with the foul on the floor. Six minutes to go now. St. Mary's hanging on to a 13-point lead. That one no good. Greer Hoyant misses. All the way to the rack, Moss, but there's DaCosta. And a tie-up called. Menlo will take back over, down by 13. The winner of this plays Pleasant Valley tomorrow night at 8:30 in the nightcap, semifinal action. The loser of this game plays Sacramento. Both of those are going to be really good games.
Oh, for sure, for sure. The competition level here at this tournament is outstanding, and you got to give credit to Coach Myrtle for putting this tournament together, bringing in some of the best teams in the state. So kudos to Carla Newman for doing that.
So far, the winner's bracket has Cardinal Newman and Campo playing at 7 o'clock tomorrow night. And then Pleasant Valley, who beat Sacramento 67-54. Pleasant Valley Chico will be in the nightcap at 8:30 tomorrow night, taking on the winner of this one.
I was really impressed with Pleasant Valley. I thought that they were very disciplined as a team. And I think that they may have more success against St. Mary's, assuming St. Mary's goes on to win this game, than Menlo-Atherton has, because they're a little bit more disciplined.
DaCosta fires up a three. Kalahi almost had that ball tapped off of her.
Coach Gonzalez a little upset right now with DaCosta taking that shot. I think he wants him to work the offense, work the clock, be a little more selective with the shots you are taking.
Greer Hoyam, nice pass. Stella Kalahi lays it in.
Go there. Stella gives it to Greer, and Greer gives it back to Stella.
10-point lead.
Menlo's both teams not out are in the bonus. They get a couple stops.
Mina Young, and she's going to shoot two.
But the stops come with rebounding. If you're not going to rebound, you're going to give them a second opportunity, then they're going to the free throw line. That's not what you want if you're Coach Coleman for Menlo-Atherton. I would say that's the Achilles heel of Menlo-Atherton here today, is that they have not been a strong rebounding team against St. Mary's of Stockton.
Nina Young gets one. 18 points now for Nina Young. Kind of a quiet 18. Both teams are in the bonus, and Young gets them both.
Well, she's a three-point shooter, and those shots do add up, so I'm not sure my stats if she has three or four of those. But
Stella getting it across. Mele dumps it down to Greer Hoyam. Nice job with the step. Doesn't get the basket, however. And here comes St. Mary's. Little carry, turnover, as Moss got a little ahead of herself on that one. 12-point game, 4 minutes to go. Still time for Menlo, but they're going to need to start making a run right now. Long pass. Mele doesn't get it. A little strong. Greer Hoyam with the offensive board. Fresh 30. Three ball does not drop that time. It's a pretty good look for Carly McClanahan. St. Mary's trying to take care of the ball now and eat some clock. Arielle Johnson goes in strong. And a tie-up call. The possession arrow favors St. Mary's.
I think Arielle Johnson got a little bit hung up there, and that's where the hand from the Menlo girl on the ball kind of caused a tie-up. Lucky they didn't get a turnover.
Bounce pass into the lane. Oliver and one. Amaya Oliver, the freshman.
And that's what a coach never wants to see. They never want to see your defense get threaded right down on an out-of-bounds play right underneath the basket, allowing an easy bucket like that, then with a foul for a three-point play.
and Oliver completes the three-point play. Amaya Oliver steps up at the right time for St. Mary's, and it's now a 15-point bulge.
It's amazing how quickly that lead can just evaporate or lengthen out, which is what they've done here. It hasn't evaporated, it's lengthened. So give St. Mary's credit to withstand the come from behind play of Menlo-Atherton.
Johnson gets it to DaCosta. Nice bounce pass to DaCosta to Ariel Johnson, who lays it in nicely. A great fourth quarter for Johnson. 12 points in the game now.
I think that's what Coach Gonzalez likes to see. You know, baskets in the paint at this point of the game. He doesn't want to see the girls shooting three-point shots at this point. You know, run some clock, execute the offense, a little backdoor play there, baseline. That's what you like to see.
17-point lead for St. Mary's. Wasn't long ago that Menlo-Atherton had cut the lead to three.
And had a chance to tie it.
Yeah, they had a shot at the three, and then St. Mary's turned it up a notch or two.
And that's what the good teams do. They, you know, they turn up the defensive intensity. Next you know, that close ball game, 3 to 5 points, stretched out to 15 or 17, and right now it's 17. This is what you get with St. Mary's. I mean, they weren't the number one team in the nation last year for nothing. I mean, they are aggressive, they're athletic, they're strong, and they are well coached.
Underneath the rack, nice pass. Stella lays it in. Very nice feed that time from Megan Sparrow. Lead for St. Mary's. Pleasant Valley waiting in the wings. They defeated Sacramento in the other quarterfinal. This tournament continues to grow and attract top teams. Rebound. Stella Kalahi. There's Greer Hoyam.
Greer Hoyam got away with the travel there for sure.
20 points for Hoyam. St. Mary's content to take the shot clock down. Nina Young tapped and kept alive by Menlo-Atherton. See if the Bears have one more run. Sparrow thought about the three and then she traveled.
That might be a makeup call for the possession before where Greer Hoyam got away with one underneath the basket.
Yeah, you're right.
Well, I give Menlo-Atherton a lot of credit. They did not quit. They battled all night long. Now they're down 13 with a minute 45 to go. This looks kind of bleak for them at this point, but give them credit. They have played a very strong game against St. Mary's of Stockton.
Ariel Johnson gets it to Nina Young. Back up to Johnson. Behind the screen from DaCosta. Taylor Thomas with the rebound.
Smart thing to do there. Get the rebound, pull it back out, run some more clock.
And a foul up top. Minute and 15 to go.
There's really no need for St. Mary's of Stockton to even shoot the ball at all unless it's a layup, because you're going to get fouled and go to the free throw line.
Johnson sinks the first one. She's had a real nice game, 15 points. And a timeout taken here by Stockton. Tom Gonzalez with a minute and 15 to go. It's going to be a 30. What a day it's been. We saw the opener, a win for Camp Olindo over St. Mary, 76-65. Then Pleasant Valley knocked off Sacramento 67-54. Cardinal Newman kind of an easy win, 63-29 over Oakland. And now here we are, St. Mary's and Menlo-Atherton. There you see the scores of the other games.
I tell you what, the semifinal games tomorrow night, you're going to have two great battles. Carl Newman going against Campolindo and Pleasant Valley going against St. Mary's of Stockton. And, you know, if you're out there listening to this cast tonight, this stream that we're putting on out there, you get a chance to come down and watch St. Mary's of Stockton play tomorrow. You really should come out and watch them play.
Johnson hits both. Minute and 10 to go. McClanahan tries the three. St. Mary's has the rebound. And 1 minute to go now. St. Mary's
and
looking
as I said
good
at the start of the game.
Showing why they're one of the top-ranked teams in the entire country.
They press from the start of the game to the end of the game.
Oliver fouled. Amaya Oliver will go to the free throw line. Foul call went against Hoyam. She's got four personal fouls now. How about that? Amaya Oliver gets her own miss, puts it back up strong, and gets it to go.
Menlo got caught sleeping there. No one blocked her out, and she went uncontested into the lane to get her own rebound, put it back up. Now she's back in the free throw line for a three-point play. And she got
wow.
it.
10 points now for Amaya Oliver.
If you work hard, you will be rewarded, and she was rewarded right there.
Nice move to the rack there by Mele Kalahi, under 30 seconds now for St. Mary's. And they lead it by 18. Definitely a score that won't indicate how competitive this game actually was as Oliver goes hard to the rack again. McClanahan has the rebound. Under five to go. And it's Kalahi who lays it in at the buzzer to give us our final score, 69-53.
Well, you know what? Again, like I said earlier, I give Menlo-Atherton credit. They did not quit. They had the opportunities. They pulled with a three with about a minute to go in the third quarter. Unfortunately, I think the depth and the athleticism of St. Mary's caught up to them in the fourth quarter. Menlo-Atherton got a little tired.
So it's a nice win for St. Mary's. They move on to the semifinals. They will take on Pleasant Valley. And I'm expecting that to be a very good game.
Definitely, definitely. I was impressed by watching Pleasant Valley earlier tonight. They're well coached, a lot of athleticism themselves. They have some big girls inside that will be able to match up with St. Mary's of Stockton. St. Mary's of Stockton won't have as easy of time rebounding against Pleasant Valley as they did tonight against Menlo-Atherton.
So there's your final, 69-53, and that is four games on the night for us. We are going to wrap things up, and we'll be back tomorrow night at 7 live for the semifinals. Until then, for Joe Passalacqua and our entire crew here at YSN365.com, I'm Dave Cox, saying goodnight from the John Fitzgerald Gymnasium.
Malloy, Emery, and Vasconi Insurance Services. A professional agency with personal service, insuring wine country since 1890. Tonight's game presented by title sponsor Cameron and Cameron Ranch and Vineyard Supply, featuring hand-split redwood posts for a beautiful split rail fence. Cameron and Cameron, delivering quality for over 40 years.